you name any place that has wrestling, they all know the Doubleday. With that being said, this week we are training to beat the stud. Right? It doesn't take technique to beat the winner. Alright? That's what we're training to do this week. Beat the guy that's bigger than us, maybe stronger than us, maybe faster than us. Alright? A better athlete. Alright, but these things can be overcome with technique. Now, on a double leg, it's all about your position. I told you last night, the strongest position in wrestling is what? My stance. I always want to be in my stance, or as close to my stance as I can possibly be in every situation. That's going to give me the best opportunity to win that I can have. Now, this whole session we're going to be using just one penetration step. All right, we'll get to other penetrations later on this week. But as of right now, does anybody know what kind of penetration step you use with the double leg? Alright, there's only four penetrations in the sport of wrestling. Somebody tell me. Somebody say, where's your step between the legs? That's not really the technical name for it, but that's what you do. Alright, where are you from? You're from Michigan, okay, I figured. Step between the legs. There we go. There we go. All right. Get the Ohio guys on. It's almost as bad as the Buffalo for Ohio State on Michigan. It's pretty good, huh? Sorry. I love you Michigan guys because I've got ammo this year. In a couple years, I won't have any ammo with hardball at home, right? Hardball too good. You guys don't like hardball?
I don't like Michigan.
You know, who do you guys root for? State? You guys root for State? Alright, State's pretty good. They beat us, what, 2 years ago? Not last year, but the year before. They're pretty good. Katie, your favorite players. I can't. Just trying to take That's good, that's good. Alright, so. Anyways, what's your name again?
Jack.
Jack is completely right. Me over toe penetration, here's what it looks like without a partner. My chest is going to come over my thighs. I take a step forward with my right leg. Do I have any lefties in here? Raise your hand if you're a lefty. Here I take a step with my right leg, my chest comes over my thigh, I drive my knee over my toe, my trail leg steps up high. That is aiming over toe penetration. The same penetration step you learned when you guys were this big and you started wrestling, or when you were this big and started wrestling. It's the very first penetration step you learned. So, I tell everybody this very first thing. If Mario's in this stance, he's in the strongest position he can be in wrestling. Now Mario has three lines of defense. He's got his head, his hands, and his hips. Alright? I have to beat his first two lines of defense before I can even get to his leg. And beat his third line of defense. Does that make sense? It's kind of like a process of elimination. I gotta do one, two, then I can do three. So first thing I gotta do is break Mario's stance. If he's in a strong position, I've gotta break that. I break that with a setup. And we're gonna start out with just a simple setup of an inside tie collar tie. I'm gonna take my left hand, I'm gonna get an inside tie here. I'm gonna grab Mario's tricep. Mario's gonna grab my elbow. Why? That's just what he does, fellas. I mean, if I grab an inside tie, he's gonna grab my elbow. He's not gonna do this weird thing where he like wraps over the top and then, like does this. No, he's gonna grab my elbow. That's how it works. All right, my right hand's gonna reach up here. I'm gonna grab Mario in a collar tie. Reach up here, grab the back of his neck. The biggest mistake you guys make when you guys get into this position is you want to wrestle from here, forehead to forehead. Now I want you to see something. Mario lets go, I'm right here. Does this look like a very good stance? No, my elbows are way out, I'm up really high, not a good position. I'm going to drop my head right here in the pocket. I'm going to actually be ear to ear with Mario. That top of my head right here with that bone that sticks up, that caveman bone there in your head. I'm going to put that right here on this collarbone. I still have an inside tie with my left hand, and I'm right here in my stance. Here's what determines this position. Right now, Mario's got his elbows closer to his stance than I do. I do this to start breaking his stance. I start pulling my elbows back to my stance, creating this space. From here, if you are right-handed this week, you are always going to circle to your left and take a shot. This will not make sense right now, but trust me, circle to your left to take the shot. I'll show you why you circle left here in a little while. But let me tell you, start circling left. Start creating a good habit. Here, I'm going to circle towards my inside thigh, towards my left. Here, as I circle, I'm going to change levels and pull down. What happens when I pull down on somebody's head? What do they always want to do? They want to raise up. So I pull down, I change levels. As Mario raises up, I take a big step with my right leg here. Notice, I haven't even hit my knee yet. I shoot both arms, I drive my knee here to the mat, and I make Mario take a step back. Here, my chair leg steps up high. From here, I'm going to go across Mario's hips. I'm going to drive up. I do this right here. From here, I'm going to circle my hips back in front. I want you to notice something. If Mario were to walk away, where am I at? I'm right in my stance. Again, inside side collar tie. Here, I circle, change level, pull down. Big step with my right leg here. I shoot both arms. My chair leg steps up high. And from here, I drive up. Now, notice my position. My hands are right here on the sides. My elbows are pulling right back into my stance. My head is high. My chest is high. My back is straight. My hips are underneath me. My ear is up here by his shoulder blade. Notice how far I've got Mario leaned over. From here, if I can stay in my stance and keep him out of his stance, I can beat him. We do that with in-tune circle back motion. In-tune motion means go across his hips. I do this. Circle back motion means I circle my hips back in front of his hips. Right here. Into him. Circle back. Into him. Circle back. The whole time, I'm right here in my stance. Biggest mistakes that you guys make is you think when you hit a double leg, you have to rack on his calves. This is false. If my hands are down on his calves, I'm in bad position. Here, I circle, change level, pull down. But I'm right here. I'm trying to drive up. Look where my head's at. Is my back straight? No, my back is flat. Are my hips underneath me? Not even close. I have never one time in my life went out, shaking hands with a guy, and seen him get a stance like this. That's just not good. They're not going to do it. Does that make sense? If you wouldn't line up and shake hands with a guy, and be in that stance, don't do it when you drive up. The other big mistake I'll see is you guys will drive up and you'll want to pull this leg to the outside. You want to be right here. You guys think this is a good position. In all reality, is this good? This is not good. I'm totally exposed. I'm in a bad stance. So here's all I want to see for now. Inside tie, collar tie. Circle, change level and directions, pull down on his head, break his stance. Then we're going to tag a double leg here. Big step, I shoot both arms, I drop over my toe, my chair leg steps up, I drive up here. From here, I went across. Now what should I do? I went into him, what should I do? Circle back, my hips circle back, in front of his hips, and I used to do this. I'm just going to stay in my stance here. I'm going to move them a little bit with the into them, circle back motion. Then my partner's going to go. We'll get to the finish here in a little bit. But for right now, all I want to see is inside tie, collar tie, double leg, drive up and move. Let's do it. 1, 2. Let's go. I told you I would see this. And even after I told you, 4 or 5 groups do this. I cannot pull the leg to the outside. If we want to beat the stud, you must do everything right. Mario, third and safe. He's a pretty tough cat. Alright? If you want to beat Mario, I promise you, you will not beat him if you pull that leg to the outside. When we get to the finish, this leg will come out from between my legs. But I can't do it when I'm moving. Also, you guys got to circle left. I got a few groups circling to the right. I have to circle left. It doesn't make sense right now. I'll make it make sense here in a little bit. You just have to trust me. Here, as I circle towards my inside thigh, to my left, take my big step, I drive. I come up, look where Mario's leg's at. It's right here between my legs. I don't want it out here. Can't have it out here.
one, two, three.